Right, so good morning all of you. So in this session, you will see the continuation of your gate drains. In the previous session, we have discussed two gate drains, simple gate drain and compound gate drain. Right, now here, reverted gate drain. Okay, so here it is just like your simple gate drain, but here it consists of two gate drives, right? Two of the gear wheels are on the same shaft. Obviously, these two gear wheels, 2 and 3, rotates with the same speed. That's why this is a compound gear. Right? So here the two shafts on which the driving gear and the driven gear are mounted are coaxial to each other, So this is the shaft on which the driving wheel is mounted. Let us take the first wheel is the driving wheel, right? And the fourth wheel is the driven wheel. So this is the driving shaft and this is the driven shaft. So these two shafts are coaxial. Whereas in the previous simple gate drains, the shafts are parallel to each other. Similarly, in compound gate drain also, the shafts are parallel to each other. But here, the shafts are coaxial. And the motion from this driving gear is transferred to the driven gear or the follower with the help of this compound gear, right? So this compound gear consists of two gear wheels, 2 and 3. Right, through which the motion is transmitted from driving one to driven member. Okay, right. So now this is the gear one, right? And this is this smaller gear is gear 4, and this dotted line represents second gear, and this outer circle represents third gear. Okay. So the motion is transmitted from this end to this end, and from there you will get finally this is the output end, this is the input end, and this is the output end, right? So let us take if the gear one or the driving gear rotates in clockwise direction, the gear two, which is mounted on the parallel shaft on which the compound gears are mounted, it is subjected to what type of rotation? This is subjected to anti-clockwise rotation. This dotted circle is the second gear. Since from here it is invisible, that's why I have shown it with a dotted line here. So this gear 2 rotates with the anti-clockwise sense. Okay, then obviously the gear 3 also follows same sense of rotation as that of gear 2, because both the gears are mounted on the same shaft. Okay, so that means the gear 3 also rotates in the anti-clockwise sense, right? Thereby this wheel rotates, the gear 3 rotates in anti-clockwise sense. If gear 3 rotates in anti-clockwise direction, the mating gear of gear 3 is gear 4, which is rotating in the opposite sense, that is clockwise sense. Obviously, the driving and driven wheels, or the driving gear and driven gear 1 and 4, both rotate in the same direction. Both the wheels rotate in the same sense of rotation. So that means input gear rotates in the clockwise sense. Output gear also rotates in the clockwise sense. So that is the advantage of this reverted gate drain. And another advantage is when the power transmitted between the shafts of coaxial orientation, then the reverted gate drain is used. Okay. So now if you want to calculate the velocity ratio for this gate drain, so this is 1 and 2 gives one gate drive, 3 and 4 gives another gate drive. One is the driver here and 3 is the driver here. So 1 and 3 are the drivers, 2 and 4 are the driven wheels or the followers. Okay, now what is the velocity ratio? N1 by divided by N2 is equal to T2 divided by T1. Similarly, for the second drive, what is the velocity ratio? What is the driver here? 3 is the driver. N3 divided by N4. Speed ratio or the velocity ratio is equal to speed of the driver divided by speed of the follower or the driven member. N3 by N4 is equal to T4 divided by T3. Now, you combine these two equations, then you will get N1 by N2 into N3 by N4. N3 by N4 is equal to T2 by T1 into T4 by T3. Right? But what about the RPMs of second and third pulley? Since both not pulleys, gear wheels, since both the gear wheels 2 and 3 both are mounted on the same shaft, both rotate with the same speed, N2 is equal to N3. Therefore, N1 by N4, that means the speed of the driver divided by speed of the follower is equal to T2 into T4 divided by T1 into T3. What is 1 and 3? 1 and 3 are the drivers, 2 and 4 are the driven members or the followers. So, speed of the driver divided by speed of the follower is equal to product of number of teeth on the followers or the driven members divided by product of number of teeth on the drivers. Right? So that's how you can find out the speed ratio. Similarly, you can find out the train value. Train value of this reverted gear train is equal to 1 by speed ratio, or N4 by N1 is equal to T1 into T3 divided by T2 into T4. That's how you can find out the train value of a reverted gear train. Okay. Then, is it clear, all of you?